Economy continues to lose momentum. Exports are largely blamed for the slowdown, but Asian Development Bank's latest report on developing Asia suggests that India has performed in line with its peers. Ira has been looking at some charts. Ira.
All right, so I think one debate is around the government's finances, the other debate is around growth. And if you've been following this growth debate, you're probably surprised by where this whole export story has suddenly come in from. For the last 2 years, nobody was talking about the export slowdown. Now everybody is talking about the export slowdown and blaming it for growth. A couple of points to make. There is no doubt that if you compare pre-crisis years and post-crisis years, the level of growth in exports has come down, and hence its contribution to GDP growth and GDP growth overall has come down. There is no debate about that at all. The question that we are asking, or the premise that I'm challenging, is whether exports in India slowing down is an India problem. And there, yesterday, an ADB report seems to suggest that perhaps it's not. In fact, that ADB report talked about how Asian economies were actually getting a little boost from exports this time around, and that made me question the data. So this is what the basic data over a period of 2010 and 2016 has looked like. Ignore the levels, because the levels are very different between, say, a China, a Bangladesh, or India, somewhere in the middle. But you'll see that apart from China, which has seen a big jump between 2010 and 2016, and a lot of that jump came in the early years, and China is a different export animal. If you look at the other guys, South America, South Korea, India, Thailand, Indonesia, Malaysia, Bangladesh, the extent of percentage increase is not that different between any of these countries. Maybe these bar graphs don't make it exactly clear. So let's look at the next chart, which is tracking the rate of growth in exports, the year-on-year growth. Again, you will see that there is not a huge difference in the trajectory that India has followed, particularly in the last year or so, and what the other countries have done. So India's growth rate has risen and ebbed pretty much in line with what the other Asian economies have done. The question then is, then why are we blaming India alone? Is this a currency story? That currency story doesn't hold water no matter which way you look at it. There is a third chart. Let's look at the current year. The current year is when all of this hype has started, right? So in Asia, and this is the number that ADB put out yesterday in support of their uptick on the growth forecast, Asian exports have grown 11%. This is in the first 5 months. That's the consolidated number that they had given for Asia. In India, that consolidated number in the first 5 months of the current calendar year is 14.9%. So I come back to the point as to where this export slowdown has come from and whether this is an India-specific story or not. Yes, in the last couple of months, there has been some short-term disruption, perhaps due to GST. But if you look at a longer period of time, and we're taking post-crisis years all the way from 2010 to 2016, the point simply is that the export slowdown is probably not an India-specific story. So while this whole growth slowdown is being explained away by saying it's exports to blame, I think people need to do a slightly deeper analysis.
I know we're in a rush to get to F&O because we need to give those cues to our viewers, but I've got to ask you about the second chart that you pointed out. I think the peaks, if you look at the growth rate trends, right?
Yeah.
The peaks and the falls, the troughs and the crests for India seem to be sharper than anywhere.
Sharper, right? Yes.
So if you look at 2013 and where we've come to in 2015, it's a far steeper slope than for many other countries.
But this is not where growth was slowing.
No, I know.
This is not where Indian GDP growth was slowing.
Curiously, the perception that exports are weaker,
yeah,
may be because we're comparing it to 2014, 13, 14, 15.
Yes.
But yeah, I get
that. There is some truth to that for sure.
The correlation to GDP numbers may not be,
It's not as absolute as it's being made out to be. Nobody is saying that they're not playing a role in it. And, certainly they're playing a role on activity in the manufacturing sector. But just saying that the assumption that this is an India-specific, a rupee-specific story, that assumption has to be challenged.
All right.